Alrighty, happy Thursday. Hey, things appeared. Alright, everybody's having a good Thursday. Almost there, chat. Five more days. I had a count in my head. Five more days. What am I dancing? Probably one of the weekends. Days. I'm probably not gonna stream on Monday. Probably one of the weekend days. Good times on. I'm sure the VOD will be saved. Oh, do some runs, shall we? Hopefully not be bad at animation canceling, even though I just haven't played for a single day. You never know. You never know. I did see you got a 218 last night. Well, I saw after the fact because I was playing games with friends during it and I stopped paying attention. And then I'm like, oh, I wonder if Cord finished a run. And then I saw his VOD was 5 hours long. So that means, that generally means that he finished a run. So I checked it out. Good run. I didn't get to see where he lost any time or how it was, but I just saw the ending. Looked like Tuna wasn't the greatest. I don't really know how the rest went based off of the splits. But it was a PP, nonetheless. No, but there's people who have the points to do it. Yeah. 218. I think it was a 218-12. It was like, yeah. Good run. What is glitchless? It means I'm not using any glitches. It's the same category I've been running. If you've watched my previous streams, I just put glitchless in the title because I felt like it. I felt like the title was the same for too long, so I changed it slightly. Respawns. I'm just not using glitches. It's really the... So, I feel like it's a little self-explanatory. If I was using glitches, I can complete the convenience center in, like, less than 30 minutes. I would just spawn in, like, every single item. I don't remember my dreams, so no. I don't remember off the top of my head. I probably have done maybe one or two, but I don't remember them. So it's not like I can really tell you. Only if we had one leak and one more leak and one less daffodil, could have been perfectly even. Why did I? You know, warm up day. Also, nice impossible horseradish, by the way. Thanks for good luck. Good leaks. Dude wasn't looking good otherwise. Kinda sucks, kinda wish I went down to get that, but I'm not walking back for that, so. Is fine. Surely we don't need the 20 extra swings. Have to go down. I brute force the ladder from my animation canceling's a little rusty right now. I should have broken one of those rocks at the start, but it's fine. Ah, if I was faster on the reaction, I could have skipped that geode cutscene. Good morning. And you break that rock, I broke the rock under it and got in the same effect. Me or does that not really feel like a Thursday? It's afternoon for the US. I guess West Coast it's kind of early, but like noon central. Pull for those crates are garbage. Should get a club on 20. A ladder on the floor. Today just doesn't feel like it has Thursday energies to me. I don't really know what it feels like. It just doesn't feel like Thursday. It was like earlier in the week to me. I need the coal at the end of this floor. I'll just skip. freebie. Probably wasn't worth killing that guy. Fez, I guess. Probably could have gotten a geo there, but. Probably should have killed that guy. And that's fine, I guess. We got an Aegeo there. Wasn't really looking very hard with my eyes. But I don't think there was a ladder on the left. This pace is really bad. We're kind of just warming up, I guess. I should be on floor, I should be on floor, like, 24 right now if this was a good pace. We're still waiting. Not much else to say. Yeah, CA said he's never patching out animation canceling. It's a feature here to stay. 1.6 is coming in 5 days. But yes. Soon. Copy. Club. Magnet ring. No. I would be playing it if it came out. Warm up, I guess. Yes, there's ways to down patch. Nice. Still got a few days if you want to do it before 1.6. Otherwise, you're probably going to have a lot more work cut out for you. Nope. 8-man farm? Yeah. Maybe. I doubt it. You'd have to make a farm map that's like specifically bigger, which is a little weird. You know, I guess the beach farm is technically bigger than the rest of the farms. Technically speaking. I should have tried to get a geode from one of those rocks. It's on the... Okay. I'll say, if I got the ladder at, like, the bottom there, I would have been upset. No geode yet, which is a little... One of the crates over here is a club. Really just starting out on runs today. I haven't gotten anything past the mines. Either get a magnet ring on 20 or a club. Case up there. We probably will, but hopefully I don't have an edge case. Figurita, thankfully I have a little bit of modding insight. He has changed or attempted, at least made attempts to fix the netcode, so hopefully it's less laggy, just in general. Not saying that they're going to solve all the problems, or it will solve all the problems, but there has at least been an attempt to change the netcode in some way. I've looked at the tweets. I don't know if he's tweeted today. I haven't read the new one. I read the other three, though. We're pretty shit on copper. I'm gonna pick this up. I'll need an earth crystal. Food's looking a little bad. One's probably the best infested floor you can get. It's nice and small, so you don't have to deal with a bunch of shit. And then you can't get a infested floor on 15. Or on, I'm sorry, on 25. Really don't have to deal with it. No club, that really sucks, because I was kind of hoping that I could just get away with monster ladders. Because our energy is terrible. Our money is awful. Isn't even good. The worst part. Oh, so it's a Twitch thing. YouTube was 100% fine. It was literally a Twitch thing. That run was shit anyways. I love how we can actually see if it's Twitch fucking up or if it's my internet now. Just because we stream on YouTube and Twitch. Actually a Twitch thing. Omega lol. No. I have a gig upload. I used to just stream to Twitch with like 10 megabits. Rip. I keep pressing E instead of 5 and it's really annoying. Sashar, thank you for the 26 months. Day. Did the tweet finally go live? Ooh, mega lol. Yeah, I figured. Does it keep it up with the trend of it being in a different font color and a different background color? Or is it the same as one of the other ones? I do love how much people are karma farming his tweets on Reddit. Speedruns are different every time. For the most part. No, mines run is realistically, like, the same. I enjoy the mines. I enjoy early game of Stardew much more than I enjoy late game. It's kind of like Minecraft in that way. I think late game becomes way too easy in this game. So it's much less fun. Because you can just do whatever you want after a certain point with no restrictions. I love floor 5. Is so much fun. Outer bottom left. You guys can't see it, but kill Dougie for cherry bomb. I've had. I guess. how I didn't switch to my law. My mouse isn't fast enough today, apparently, to do it. Thank you for the 5. I'm definitely not walking all the way down there. You know, I was thinking that I should kill those guys, but I decided not to. And then I get punished for it. Go average. No. Just need to move the mouse faster. I was doing it consistently yesterday with hitting the... Yeah, I know what you meant by the multicolor thing. I've seen it and attempted to use it before when I was doing some other mines run. I think it was mines 120. It didn't really work in my head very well. Could have broken that rock. You were probably trying to explain it to somebody else. Never mind. Streamer bias. You know, I love how I placed that, assuming that I would get the ladder from it. But I started walking away. That was bad. Yeah. So I started walking away. What a waddle. And then I didn't get it, so I had to do. Type in your chat, I'm obviously talking to you, yeah. Yep, yep. Where is the freebie? Down from where I wanted it to be, but whatever. Didn't put away the... Yeah, whatever. Club. We'll probably be getting a amethyst, so I'm just gonna place that. No amethyst. Still don't really regret the cherry bomb, but that's fine. Food's not great. Food's not great, and money's not great. Copper's pretty good, though. No magnet ring moment. We'll just get a diamond here, and then our money problem's fixed. They'll have a food issue, but... figure that out. We're good on copper. Honestly, realistically, my money is so bad that I probably still need more money, even with a diamond. Miranda, thank you for the tier one for 10 months. Greatly appreciate it. Hope your day is going well. All right, 10 floors with cave carrots and 2 parsnips, the dream. Really, we just get ladders from enemies or just ladders right away from just rocks. List. Yeah, who needs the energy anyways? Get lucky, forehead. Just get lucky. That works. Honestly, it's really just get lucky. They'll need a little bit of copper, but I was avoiding it because I need to make sure that I could get the ladders over. Hopper. Get freebie on this floor. 5 swings left. This is where the run dies. Right here. Really? Money ended up being okay. I mean, bailed out because of the diamond, but even without that, it ended up being okay. All right. Need 8 copper, 70 iron. Aqua, frozen tier, frozen geode. Ideally, seven more coal.
And then whatever extra money we could get, like a few jades.
I technically also need a leak still, but we could get that in on the 13th, so not too worried about that. I don't like going for this. I could have just, like, reset two floors in that time. That guy is not worth going for. I do not need a lead rod in this run. Need to be more aggressively resetting. That ladder just felt bad going for. A little bit, not too much. Killed that guy in Valid Tile. Thank you, little guy. Ideally, we get two more coal. More iron. Honestly, I'm gonna cherry bomb this and then just get one more copper instead. Gives energy. Should have picked up that last copper node then. Ignoring that, but what can you do? Realistically, I think the Hyrule play is the cherry bomb that. But fine. Yeah, Hyrule play was definitely the cherry bomb. Fine, nonetheless. Hey, Pete. A good run. Only reason it's kind of acceptable is because of the diamond. Actually, poor is the funnier part. Really, if I got anything else from that node, it would have sucked. Funny enough, I actually misremembered and I don't need a leak this run. I need a Daffodil, actually. Not the case, but that's fine. Probably need about 8 extra. I'll just not fill up that last one right there. Be fine. Glorious, thank you for the 3 years. Hope your day is going well. Thank you for the lasting support. Means a lot. Be allowed to keep doing what I'm doing. Mistake. Probably shouldn't have walked back into the house. I don't have nearly as much time as I thought I did, but. I don't think I've ever had a run where I don't have a Daffodil. And they can't spawn on the farm. It does. It feels atrocious, and I hate it. But I don't want to get ferried. Also, it makes it easier to spot where Waldo is. They look like fucking Waldo. Well, I know what the worst part is. Now that I'm zoomed in, I really don't want to be fully zoomed in because I need to get a daffodil still, and that's easier to find when you're zoomed out. Because I need to go to the bus stop. Zoom out just a little bit here. We'll go out tomorrow for it. See, this is why I wanted to be zoom out in case it was this far. Run could have been so good if I got a daffodil on the first check. But how it goes, we'll break even. I'm doing a perfection speedrun as soon as 1.6 comes out, so yes. I don't know how casuals play like this. If we get a ferry, the ferry takes less time to travel to the crop, which saves us a little bit of time. Going up crops, there's a chance that I make ferry, or ferry shows up, and it's annoying. I have definitely seen streamers play at this Zoom before, and this is like the default Zoom for mobile players. Kind of entertaining. Playing this zoomed in just hurts my eyes half the time. And it feels so restricting. You. Don't need that, need that. I guess I can bring that. I just want to get a fairy so I don't have to be zoomed in anymore, because there's a two-month down period between being able to get another fairy. If I get a fairy right now, I can just fully zoom out and I don't have to worry about anything. Also, I got so many rain days in... Oh, I was about to say, I got so many rain days in spring, I would be surprised if I got a rain day in summer. I still need one more rain day. One more natural rain day. We will get one tomorrow. Oh, we're good on rain. We're guaranteed four now. Guaranteed one on the 13th, and we're guaranteed another one on the 26th. Thank you for the raid. Hope your stream went well. Silver quality. We're playing on mobile, not really, but we're playing on mobile with the Zoom. Forest farm only. But yes, it can. Surely the one day that I zoom out here, the one day we don't get a crop fairy tomorrow for this one crop that's right here. The only crop that's not grown. Surely I don't get a fairy tomorrow. I zoomed out early one day. Bless. Wow, I don't think I've ever seen Forge like this before. But we're good on Forge chat. Don't need to worry about the summer Forge. I have an extra tomato I can eat. I'm just not gonna worry about picking up this other grape. I can eat the extra tomato, I can eat the hot pepper, I can eat the potato. I have inventory room that I can remove if needed. Alright, need iron. Iron, coal, bat wings, solar. That let's delete that instead. All right, tell you this day is not gonna go well. Saved. I want to cherry bomb this. Yes, probably. Not anymore. Iron. I get a magnet ring from this guy, I guess. Cool. Eat the spud. I need one more Batwing, still need the... One more Batwing, need the other thing. Thank you for not selling me, kind sir. I am gonna eat this tomato, because I'm probably gonna break a few more things, and I just want the inventory spot. Do not eat the melon. I would throw this run on the spot. There's iron there, but I need to be aggressively resetting for a ghost. Go. Need the one grape so we can get the remainder of this iron. Gonna get 0.5. That gonna actually spawn, or is it just trolling me a little bit? Doing a little bit of trolling. It's fine. Solar, right? Yep. Reset 45 until we get a bat spawn on our screen. We don't need to upgrade any of our tools besides the axe because we're not allowed to chair hop into the secret woods because it's considered a progression skip. So the only tool we upgrade in this run is the axe. I think the axe is the only tool that you upgrade in any speedrun outside of perfection where you upgrade your pickaxe as well. But upgrading your hoe and watering can is grief because it makes animation canceling slower, and I can animation cancel as fast as an iridium hoe. So what's the point of upgrading it? What's the point of wasting money if I can already do it as fast as an iridium hoe and watering can? I think we have exact, which is scary. I'm gonna open this just in case. I don't know why I opened that. That was kind of a waste. I think we have exact. I might be too coal off though. I don't know how many bars we have to smelt. This is a little scary. I mean, we can just skip out on 3 if needed. Probably zoom in case if I get a fairy at this point. Nah, we won't get a fairy. Trust. I'll just rain every day so we can't get a fairy to spawn. I need an inventory, weirdly. Yeah, we do have exact WoW. Quick seizure warning on this day. We'll be spam opening mail. 2, 3, 4. I should have put the bat wings away. Keep the solar. Whatever. The menu slow. We have the inventory space anyway, so it's not the end of the world. And remove that log. One, two, three, four. Good to go. Good to go. Good to go. A little slow here in the morning. All right. Yeah, it's pretty good. Yeah. We're cruising. Good for the few menuing mistakes that I've been making, but it hasn't been that atrocious. Mine's luck has been pretty good as well. Why don't you buy the biggest backpack? Because it's literally worthless. We don't need that much inventory spots. 10,000 gold is a lot of gold. That is literally a house upgrade worth of money. That was a very nice menu.
Only if the morning was better.
It gives me exact money for what I want to buy on the next day. 75 blueberries. So it allows me to just free buy as many pumpkins as I can. Which is much faster than having to buy it an exact amount. And then it saves the exact money that I want for the next day that I go out. If you sell them last, yes, and that's why I specifically sell the big clump of them last. I guess I should be zoomed out so I can see bubbles, but buy 47 pumpkins next time. Yeah, it's whatever you buy last. I mean, I turn in the wheat in the morning there, so I don't have to worry about it, but probably a sardine, isn't it? Could be a sunfish, but it's probably a sardine. Snapper. I did not expect a snapper. Not gonna lie. Out of all the fish that could have been, I was not expecting a snapper. Also, not expecting that to be a sea cucumber. That's fine. Perfect catch. Free XP. We'll need it. Good pass out fish as well.
Another snapper.
That's a different category in and of itself. Like an hour or so longer. Don't judge the high roll. It rolls two individual numbers, Angie, a number between 0 and 100, and then a decimal point. It doesn't actually roll with a decimal point. It rolls two separate numbers. So theoretically, the highest you can get is 100.99%. Yeah. This is an anchovy. I'm gonna lose it. Or you can, yeah. Close.
What's wrong?
Ah, this is a salmon that baited me hard. I thought it would be a tiger trout. Fishing is not going well today. It took us 6 hours to get two fish. Another bait salmon. Fuck off! How long? Oh my god. It has been forever since I've been baited by a salmon like that twice. Just even baited by a salmon in general, and then it happens to me twice.
Ain't no way.
Yeah, we're good on fishing XP. Shouldn't it be that often, unless if you get a perfect catch like that, and you get a lot of perfects. This is a salmon. What am I fucking doing? Stop wasting so much time. You should know it's a salmon instantly. They don't have those weird fucking wait times to go up. Pushing the training rod so I can at least get walleye. I love max wait time rings. It's gonna be another shad. I should be able to throw one cast. As long as they don't have to wait 20 seconds. Thank you. Not terrible, I guess. Hopefully there's no bubbles. Actually, I guess I can... Here. I check for bubbles. V bakes the cookies. You made the command, she makes them. No, it's for Crop Fairy. PM heal's not the worst. This is why we're zoomed in. Woo! Fuck you, fairy.
Look how much faster she is.
Well, I mean, when you reset constantly, you get a lot of fairies because it's a 1% chance per year. Or, I'm sorry, a 1% chance per day. So, on average, you'll get about one fairy a year. I just wouldn't implement it. It's literally the time difference of, like, 15 seconds if you get a fairy. If you get two, it's 30, but it's probably just not worth it. As a pain in the ass, it makes the viewing experience a lot worse. It's nauseating. I really don't like doing it. I'm kind of just doing it for the meme recently. Definitely not needed. I need 47. Seconds. Yeah, I mean, 15 seconds definitely matters a lot more for me than for other runners.
Thank you.
Now, I kind of find it crazy that the one Fall Forge that I'm missing is the Blackberry. Money is important here. For a little. This run's probably poor, and I'm probably gonna reset it. Fish didn't go great. I mean, the EL timing wasn't bad. I'm technically a minute ahead of PB, but I mean, if I have to chop down trees, the run's essentially dead. Actually, I think we're fine. It's like two trees. 31 wood, 3 trees. Pog, a golden kappa. I feel like I've been seeing those a lot more recently. Two levels from that. I remember it being a lot less. Your kappa has a random chance of it being golden every day. I don't know what the exact odds. I remember it being like a handful of accounts get it per day. Like a handful of accounts, not like a 1% chance for all users, because then you'd get a lot more golden kappas. Oh. Okay. Thank you. This run basically lives and dies off of a fast tuna, by the way. I mean, that's like every run, but this run, like, in particular, very much so. Run's not necessarily all that good. And my end game is crazy, so I kind of need to save time now. And the two best splits that I can save time for is tuna and summer fish. So as long as I don't really bleed much time from here on out. Yeah, I mean, fishing's just the worst segment in my PB. All three fishing days are kind of... Like, tuna's okay, but the other two are bad. God damn it. I had to think about it too much. It's okay. That's okay. It's pace, but it's not good pace. Or not great. He will gift us a fire quartz. Slow. My brain turned off. Crystal fruit still. I mean, I can get it next year, but it's fine. Wood bunny is not great. Eh, we're getting crystal fruit next year, I guess. Okay, the items are on really bad hotkeys. I'm just gonna... old-fashioned way. Water. All right, the run also lives and dies off of sunfish here. Should put the copper bars away as well, but yep, this is year two. Surely I don't get a bunch of small mouse and trash here. That wastes all my time, right? I kind of need sunfish first try here, otherwise I'm losing way too much time. Pretty sure this is a smallmouth. GG's. I should probably just reset this now. Playable. It was a fast second ring, but I basically lose 20 seconds to that. That was the most awkward buy I've done in a while. It's just so hard because I know my PB has a crazy endgame, so it's really annoying to compete with it if I'm not ahead now. And that's kind of the issue. This one's not great, unfortunately. It has its issues. I'm missing a lot of fish. That's the main thing. A lot of fish. Pretty low on this run, to be quite honest. Probably lower than I should be. It's not that bad. I just know that a lot of things need to come together for it to, like, actually work out, and it's like the odds of that happening are slim. I'm kind of just like, you know, a little bit on this run. Oh, did a sprinkler get destroyed? Oh, lol. I had a sprinkler destroyed. That's a new one. Doesn't matter at this point. Oh, that's kind of funny. And that's what I get for not really clearing very well. I guess I'm turning that in so I can do that. Yo, what the fuck? Debris is so aggro today. Like, literally blocking two tiles there. Huh? It took me so much longer to clear than it ever should have. Interesting. Alright, Tuna. You need to show up in like the next two casts or it's probably just a reset. See how long it actually takes, because if it's like this next two casts, it's like okay, and kind of just bank on Summerfish being good, but it's probably not. I guess I didn't bleed that much time to my own stupidity this run. Kind of fine with it dying to fish. Try to make an auto splitter for Core Keeper. Oh boy. Boy, oh boy. Oh, rip. I don't know if he can, like, unless if he does, like, a longer category, I don't know if he can get the world record unless if he downgrades patches, because the bosses were made harder. The game was just made harder in general. Oh. Thank you, Tuna. Put her on. I'm going to the bathroom real quick. I am referring to Core Keeper, yes. I had a part of it working last night, but now it's not splitting right. Classic.
And well.
I do want to go and speedrun Core Keeper again at some point. I just 1.6 don't really have the attention span. Say that with a lot of games as well. It's like I say, I want to go back and speedrun Starbound again, but when will I actually? Don't know. Probably not. Yeah, maybe. Actually played Slime Rancher. It's kind of funny, but I know I play a lot of Stardew, but I'm like not huge into like the farming sim genre as a whole. Like it takes a very specific game for me to enjoy that type of genre, and Stardew is kind of like that only game. I don't really play games that similar to Stardew often. Stardew isn't a farming simulator. That's kind of like why I'm also somewhat attached to Stardew, because I don't play it like a farming simulator, where every other game that is trying to, you know, be the next Stardew is an actual farming simulator. Never played Sun Heaven. I hear good things about it, I just haven't bothered. I chopped down too much wood again. Yeah. Agreed. I don't need to do it, and it's inefficient, and it loses me time, and it's me just being nitpicky. It also messes with my inventory. That's not a huge deal, to be quite honest. I'm not even talking about the cozy part, though. I'm just talking about, like, the farming simulator part in general. I mean, I think it's pretty obvious based off of my general game selection that I don't really care about the cozy part in games either. Can it be nice? Sure, but it's like, I don't care. That's my favorite game. It changes depending on what I want to play. Different games. Wow, I got two leaks in like the most polar opposite ends, and I don't want to get either of them because they're so far. I mean, it depends on the game that I want to play. Stardew for like farming sims, sure. Want to go into like MOBAs or like competitive games, I would say it's League. As bad as that is to say. For action platformers, Terraria. They kind of all do a different niche. It's not just one thing. Going for this, but I am. You know. It's kind of hard to compare Terraria to Stardew. It's like comparing an apple to an orange. Hard to compare League to Terraria and Stardew. Literally a fucking... trying to compare vegetables to fruits. Doesn't work. Makes no sense. Tomatoes, yeah. Makes no sense. I'll say what my favorite game is. I can tell you my most played game of all time is Stardew, and I can tell you that is an objective fact. But sometimes I don't want to play Stardew anymore, and I just want to take a break from it. Happens often, more often than you would think. Why did I delete my sword? Oh well, I have a dagger now. It's fine. Opie. To try games. I actually speedran Cuphead when it first came out, but there was a trick in it that hurt my wrist. It's like animation canceling, but like actually constant. Up and swap glitch. Basically, I had it basically the exact same way as Stardew, where you press spacebar to switch weapons rapidly, but you're literally switching weapons the entire fight. So it's literally just like 25 minutes of spamming spacebar. Not fun. It's like, yeah, I can't give you one answer for my favorite game. I mean, I can tell you the facts about the amount of hours I put into games, but... I have 4 cherry bombs. That's probably just gonna be reset. Yeah. Does that have high enough damage? I crit more often, sure, but I don't know if I just got unlucky or if extra crit chance doesn't mean anything, basically. Pace isn't horrendous. Why did I make it a... I mean, there was high odds that it was Monster Floor on 22. Quite fair. You know, it's kind of like a feels bad man and a feels good man to get a run or run so deep early, because it's like, oh man, we got a run so early. That's nice. I can try to do another one. But at the same time, it's like, if I don't get another one quickly, then it's kind of just like, pain. Change. I don't really like Marriage Percent runs very much. They have a really annoying reset point early, and then to get a good time, you're basically praying for 6 rain days in summer, which is not fun. I mean, yeah. I'm kind of just, like, at the point where it's like I'm really just waiting for 1.6, and I'm not entirely motivated to do CC runs, but I just... don't really know what else to do, and I don't want to just not stream. I don't want to get, like... I mean, I guess I won't get out of practice for not streaming for, like, a few days at this point, but... yeah. To a degree. Marriage runs, at least specifically for Shane, because that's the only category I would do, is literally waiting for what, like a 7-10% chance to get the bulletin board quest that's acceptable, and you have to sleep 19 days right at the start for a 10% chance. Basically similar to the mines shenanigans. 10% of runs really get past the mines. Yeah, everybody's waiting. I know it's not just me, but... Eh. She's close to Shane because the Shane run is not optimized. And the reason why I say that is it looks optimized on paper, but if I remember correctly, I think I got that run with a 4 rain day summer. Every rain day is 20 seconds. So literally, if I just get a 6 or 7 rain day summer, it's a minute faster by default. Not to mention, I don't think it's taken advantage of any of the 1.5.6 hotkeys, which would make it even faster with being able to move the bed and such. Not that much worse. Yeah. There's a lot of things that can be much better. I hate getting like the dark green. It's like the greenish yellow boss slimes. They're more common, but they have so much more HP than like the light green or like the regular green color. Are you gonna continue the grind cord, or are you just gonna say fuck it and just wait for 1.6 at this point? And then do 1.6 shenanigans? Or are you gonna do something similar to me where you're basically just gonna continue running it because you don't really want to do anything else, and then when 1.6 drops, just fucking do 1.6 shit? Good luck with that. The grind mindset. Lovely. Why you have to slow me? What did I do to you? I have like no copper. My floor 19s have not been nice today. Not had good floor 19s. On it, please. Murder their entire family. I have not killed I guess I killed one slime this run. You can't even make the argument that I'm invading their homes, because if I leave and come back to the same floor, they would be gone. That's not even their home. No, Corey got a 218 last night. Cape carrots. No club though, sucks. That is, I mean, that's like the only day where money actually like is tight, because after that it's consistent. Because you always have the 40 pumpkins into whatever you jar. There's literally no inconsistencies after. That day just matters about how much wood and stone you got from the mines. Wood, stone, and coal is what makes it fluctuate. And then also how many gold qualities versus gold and silver qualities you got versus regular qualities. So it actually has variance. The other days, this door was balls. Ladder's just gonna be that first rock. Yeah, I'm just trying to beat my own record currently. You could say. I'm more just biding my time until 1.6. Having a weapon. I got the day 5 Taurus sword. I'm gonna play this until I'm 40 and then try to YOLO the club in the club spot. Got the cave carrots.
Makes the dark floors a hassle not being able to kill monsters for ladders. Oh, blind should have seen that right away. Nine copper. Picking up more. Money's okay. I don't need to worry about it. You'll worry a little bit about copper. Base is okay. Barrels. Another cave carrot, okay. Copper kind of blows, but what can you do? Nope. Players in that end in five cannot have freebies. See it if there is one. One over there either. Man, we could have had a good pace if these last few floors weren't garbage. Don't see it, man. Didn't exist. It's like here. You know, this crate spot. Probably not. It'd be the dream, but let's be real. Probably not.
We getting 210 before Tuesday? Kidding.
We had one good round that made it to tuna, but wasn't great. Fishing wasn't great in it. Kind of got snubbed. Kind of cursed. I'm just trying to get, like, a crate to spawn on this left-hand side, by the way. Play this. Can't really get a weapon anymore. I have the coal, so I don't really need to worry about killing dust sprites. The issue is getting to 45. Already at 18 minutes, and I still need 25 more iron. Weird. I mean, I was trying to hard force a weapon at the end there. Day one pace wasn't great as well, anyways. Yeah, the pain is I gotta kill the ghost. I need a weapon for it, essentially. Technically, I can get a weapon on the floor, 50 chest, but... Wow, I actually got 0 crates here. Interesting. That's a new one. This run just has no cash. Also, I won't be able to get bat wings. I'm kind of just curious how fast this pace would be. But I can kind of already see how fast the pace is, and it's not good. I wasn't paying attention. I only saw the one on the left. it doesn't matter if there's two leaks on the farm. That just means we're just not going to get any good luck day on the 5th or the 6th. Never mind. Oh, another one's there. Oh, that's a nice spot. Oh, there's three leaks on the farm. Holy shit. Also, apparently I miswatered that. Oh, well. Damn drop, but we can also go for a leak record. We're at 4. 5. Doesn't look like the best backwoods for it. Okay, we got 2. That's fine. We're at 6. 7 total. Eight. Ah. No leak record. It do be an 8 leak run, but it's not a leak record. I've had double digits before. Gem note on first floor. Easiest topaz of my life. To counteract that diamond earlier. Let's be real. Best luck day, by the way. So disappointing. I got so excited when I saw that, and then I realized it was the 6. And then immense disappointment came across me. That message, Core, that message has such bad energy. You just type the full name instead of just doing like CCGG or like CG. You type CCGG11 and you didn't even like at them. So it wasn't even like the at thing. You just typed out their full name. I don't know why that's so funny to me. You forgot the last number. Jada Goodset. Wow, look at this, guys. Wow, I'm so glad we got 8 leaks on this day. Man, so useful. Games like, I'll trade you 3 leaks last run for a dandelion. It's an equal trade. I technically can, I think. Oh, okay.
Honestly, low-key, this is the first fairy I've had in the first 5 days in a hot minute.
Second. Off-screen monster ate me. We'll give it a few more attempts. I'm kind of lacking motivation today, ain't gonna lie. I gotta find something else to do tomorrow. Be quite honest. I had the one good run to Tuna today, but Tuna kind of sapped my energy, not gonna lie. I don't know what I'll do tomorrow. I definitely need to get away from CC though.
Also, probably a good idea to not burn myself out of Stardew right before 1.6 comes out. Also be probably beneficial. So good luck. Just dance, yeah. But I mean, I still have 5 days, so it's kind of like something to do the other few days. Just dance streams, I'm good. Yes. The day of. Surely I won't need that parsnip.
Blueless.
Will the game even let me get to the mines? At the secret 14 parsnip strat? Like the Red Zelda from like that one Lynx game. I don't know which one it's called. The Four Heroes one. Four Swords, yeah. Sounds right. The 1-2-3 first split is so satisfying because it's 1-2-3. Oh. Rip that run. I mean, with this luck at this point, I'm just doing... My last run will be the next run that just gets into the mines. Kind of regardless as it goes. So this is just disappointing now. Sometimes. Counting is a powerful tool in this world, and I can't do it. I would play Junimo Kart over Prairie King. I could do that for a little bit, but... Streaming long while speedrunning is not really a great idea, at least for me, because I lose focus, and if I'm just going to lose focus later into the run, I'm just wasting my time, because I want the run to be good. If I'm not focused by the end of the run, I'm just going to be trolling and losing a bunch of random time that I shouldn't be losing. That's why I don't really like to stream long when I do, speedruns.
Especially long ones.
Farmer looks like Jess. The game, are you gonna let me in the mines or are you gonna give me like the 10th bad luck day in a row? How's this gonna be? I want good luck day to go to the mines. So I need a good luck day on the 5th or the 6th because the mines doesn't open up until the 5th, and then Forge resets on the Saturday to Sunday day transition. So if I don't get the good luck day in the first 2 days, I just reset. I want the extra Forge. And I know it's good luck because I'm checking, I know if it's good or bad luck because I'm checking the fortune teller on the TV, and I'm honestly just getting pretty unlucky here. Each day has a 35% chance of being a good luck day, and I'm like, what, 10 checks now without a good luck day? So I've lost 10 35% chances in a row. Always fun. any of the individual bundles that is not bulletin board. Okay, we've been trolling with cutting down these trees slightly, and I'm still not resetting because I just want to get into the mines. That's a really terrible start. I think mines 50 is a bad starting category, even though that's kind of like the go-to suggestion. I think boiler room is the better category if you want to learn the mines. Just don't do the Omni Geode shenanigans. Early owl.
Really, the owl means good luck, right?
Yay! I finally get a good luck day, and this is the forge. Lovely. One leak. One leak. let's hope I get cave carrots. I'm kind of done after this run. I might play some Junimo Kart, but... game kind of sapped my motivation. And why play a game if you're not enjoying it? It's a video game after all. You should have fun. I keep going. I need to stop. Rip that. Pacing. Really wouldn't say anything else about this run, but pace be pacing. Get this guy. Oh man, that the carving knife, the best weapon in the game. Starting to check those double hit rocks a little bit more. I used to be actually against hitting like double hit rocks at any time, but it's like if there's no rocks near me and I don't really want to do extra walking, I'm down to take the chance. Losing 2 energy. Slowed here, aren't I? Oh, he's unseated, yes. Seated runs are kind of boring. Well, to be fair, seated Remix Community Center is actually interesting. I just don't run it. Seated base community or base community center is boring. I'm also just not a fan of seated runs. That game's like Vanished. I played it. They're okay. Okay, it's fun to just turn your brain off. I'm not huge into city builders though, no. I prefer like Cult of the Lamb style like city builders and that where you like you go out and get resources and it's not just like the top-down view and you wait for your workers to generate like everything for you. I prefer myself going out to go do the farming. It's on RimWorld. Never played it. I've seen gameplay of it. It's kind of similar in that regards. No, never played RimWorld. That one's more active, though. You kind of, like, exactly tell your people what to do, and then they do it. Like, status effects or whatever. Character types. Yeah. I'm not huge into, like, RTSs in that regard. I wouldn't think I'm naturally good. I'm not good when you have to look at a bunch of information fast and like decipher that information in a very short amount of time. I'm better with like the shorter form where it's like visual and it's like kind of knowing what the other person will do. I'm not like graphs or whatever. I mean, but Terraria is visual. It's not looking at like graphs and like numbers to see like, oh, I need more of this. Oh, my money is low. Oh man, my fucking this resource is low or this resource is low. And I'm fixing that. Kind of bad. I mean, like, 4 is a fine amount. It just sucks because of how pitiful my food situation just is in general. Like, 4 is like an average amount. So normally I wouldn't complain about 4, but I needed a bailout, so here I am complaining about 4 carrots. I kinda wish I accidentally. Oh well. I'll play some Genoa Kart. I'm done with CC runs for today. That last floor was infested, by the way. Just a little bit. And Don't Starve, I haven't played it enough. I couldn't even tell you how many days I survived on that Halloween stream. We didn't make it to the next season change, I don't think, though. But yeah. Not doing any more CC runs. I'm kind of out of focus and just... tilted. Not really tilted. Just, like, not feeling it today. So we'll chill out with some Junimo Kart. I don't know what I'm doing tomorrow. I doubt I'll do more runs tomorrow because I'm kind of just like at that point where I should just do something else. But I don't know what I want to do. I do owe a Just Dance stream, but I'm probably going to do that over the weekend, over like tomorrow, but we'll see. I've been doing Community Center for a hot minute, so, yeah. I have no, like, concerns about taking a break and feeling bad about it. I'm just more dating the plans. Tenkwota. I really have no motivation to do Tenkwota either. Take a break. Eh. I'd honestly probably be the smart thing to do so then I can actually get a video out as fast as possible, but it doesn't feel right not streaming some days. Yesterday I was kind of out of it because I did taxes yesterday, and then when I finished, I'm kind of just like sitting there like, huh. Oh, weird. I mean, I take breaks, and I know I do. But I also need to work to provide for myself. Against taking breaks. Taking too many... or at least I feel like I'm taking too many. Love taxes. Yeah, probably. Really? I missed that jump. Yeah, and that's kind of the thing. I don't want to burn myself out of Stardew. I also just feel wrong not streaming. So it's like, I want to stream something, I just don't know what. Where's the biggest improvement? Oh, wait. Where's the biggest improvement opportunity for your runs other than just getting perfect RNG? The end, I messed up by forgetting the wood, so I probably lost about a minute to that. That was that. I mean, it's a hard question because a majority of my time save in my PB is from fishing. So it's like, that's technically just RNG, but it's like the fishing was so bad, I should have, yeah, I mean, menu up Yeah, menu optimizations is also another thing. That's just always a thing. But it's like a majority of it is just straight up fishing. And then not being slow on menus. Because sometimes my brain just lags and I sit in a menu for longer than I should before I start doing the things that I need to do. And then sometimes my fingers hesitate to click because I don't want to shift click and buy like 25 of an item that I don't need. So it's like the menuing is technically slow in that regard. Yes, but the issue is the timing's always so awkward because you need the axe to be able to clear the stuff in spring. So it just like, we have never found a way to get it to work out like that. Because by the time that you have all the bars ready to smelt, you either need it for a season transition because we only go out 2 days in a season, or you need it to clear the farm. And that's, like, the issue, and you don't want to go running back. That's, like, the last, like, honestly, like, big routing time save, I feel like, that we have in this individual route. But it's just so awkward, because then we have to shift around money and do other things. There's yellow twigs. Yeah, I had a sprinkler break in that tuna run. And I broke the twigs. So we'd have to, change money around a little bit because we don't have enough money. We're like 2K short. If you lose more than one, yes. Well, actually, no. If you lose 16 cauliflower, you're kind of fucked. And on money. I don't know why I made that. I don't think there's any other gifts that we can normally take. We'd have to move it to later in the run, realistically, but then we're just doing more visits to Clint because we're buying like the ore from Clint. I mean, I guess we could technically buy it in the end of winter and then shift it to it would be spring first. No, because then you have it happen in summer. I mean, I guess it's not as bad if it happens in summer. But you'll, like, losing red cabbage is still annoying. Because then it would be, like, it would be summer first. I'm sorry, it would be spring first, summer first, and then you pick it up on the 13th. Or it could be summer first, summer 13th. Nah. Oh, yeah, yeah. And then you pick it up on summer 18th. You warp to the beach and then you walk over to Clint's before you go up to Robin's. It'd have to be those days. Right. So summer 1st, summer 13th, and summer 18th would be the 3 days you go. But we'd normally... I guess we'd normally just go on those days anyway. Oh, I didn't jump. We'll have to see what they're setting up. I know there's a few things in the works, but I don't think I'm allowed to leak anything, so... Yeah. You know, those days might actually unironically work, by the way. The only shitty part is. You still need to go to Clint's on Fall 15th for the 85 coal. You just wouldn't buy the... Or, I'm sorry, 80 coal. You just wouldn't buy the copper and iron. Or the copper on that day. And then you would buy everything else on in winter. What am I doing? Playing Genomo Kart. I'm kind of done with CC runs. Right now. Not a great day for runs, and I'm kind of unmotivated, so. Playing Genomo Kart instead. Killing. I'm talking about the route, though, which is kind of funny. I don't know how much realistic time that would save. Because you would only take out... You'd take out the pathing to Clint's on spring 1st, and that is it. You would still go every other day. And optimally, you start at Clint's, so the only time that you would save is the time walking from Clint's to Pierre's. That is the only time save in doing it like that. So, I could probably go and time that. With coffee, by the way, so even less. Of course, I'm excited for the update. Yeah, so the only time that theoretically would save is the walk from Clint's to Pierre's. Like, on what days, though? But on what days? Because you gotta go home and plant a majority of them. Year 2 Robin Day. Yeah. But how are you exhausting? Well, I guess you clear the trees enough. I mean, we should probably just be doing that one. We buy down to min anyways. Morning's too tight on that day. Morning's too tight on that day. That would waste time. We hardly have enough time to get the Clint's. We exhaust the majority of the way on the trees anyways, it's fine. The cabin would need to be like right next to the house. It can't be in like that weird spot next to the entrance on the left. It's like realistically the only pass out though. Funny enough, the solution to that piano is probably unironically doing more cauliflower than what we do. Because it's the only time where we don't have fully filled in sprinklers. Our summer sprinklers are basically at capacity. I think there's like 10 to 15 spots not filled. Yeah, but when do we do it before shops open? The only time we would ever be able to do it before shops opened is if we do it before the day that we upgrade the house, and that's generally the day that we need to still either get wood or we're getting tiger trout and everything beforehand. We're almost always chopping down wood before something opens. The only other time is the bus stop. But again, we're generally doing some— why am I missing such easy jumps? We're generally doing something else. We could literally probably route in 20 more cauliflower and then never have to chop wood again. Let's be real. Well, no, we have to do it beforehand because we would have to buy it. Oh shit, wait, no, that doesn't work. Yeah, we would have to do more sprinklers, piano. Because we would have to gain the extra money before winter. We're already at full crop capacity. We would legit have to do more sprinklers. I don't know if 49 blueberries does that. Eight hundred. Actually, I guess that is probably enough. 800 times, 800 times 4. So what? That's an extra 260 wood? I mean, yeah, that solves it. Would need, 5 more iron, 5 more copper, which isn't the end of the world. And then we don't need to worry about that 5 copper, or 5 copper, 5 iron. We're on. I'm trying to think of how that affects menuing, and it seems like a hassle. Well, I guess it shouldn't, because we end up, with the extra blueberry money, we end up buying coal, which the coal would just translate into extra wood later. Yeah, but that's 250 wood. That's generally about the amount that we chop down at the end of the run, on like a unlucky run. My PB chop, I chopped what, 100? That bubble. Realistically, we'll just do greedier minds threes with it. Not untrue. Is it really that much harder though, Cord? It's 5 copper, 5 iron, and 2 coal. A lot of the times we end up with like the 5 extra iron anyways. Yeah, that's the other thing that I was thinking about. Yeah, but where do we get the money for the 4 blueberries? We need better money on Mine's Day 1 and 2. Because the strawberries aren't enough. Like, unless if you get the money for the strawberries or all the strawberries, you can't afford it. And sometimes, even if you low roll with 30 strawberries, you can't afford all the blueberries. Because you end up with, like, 200 G left over. That's not enough for 4 blueberries. Depends on how you roll on gold quality parts or things. So 3. Are they 50 each? Yeah, blueberry packets are 50 each, right? 80. Oh yeah, so 160. Yeah, we need 240 extra. Yeah, I'm obviously not saying it's impossible. It's just some runs will just flat up die to money. Get 3 more topaz, yeah. Just have everything go right. Just have it be a seated run instead, and then you don't need to worry about this. We're chilling now. I was doing speedruns for about 3 hours, and I got one good run, died to tuna, and now we're kind of just debating the route. I think the real, I think it is free time save to maybe look at changing up the axe timing to... What did I say? Summer 1st, summer 13th, and summer 18th. So you don't have to do that weird window, because theoretically it just cuts out walking time from Clint's Pierre's one of the days. Unless if there's dumb money consequences. Eleven less weed is also super annoying to not buy. Or to buy. It just makes the menuing slower. Cause what? That's 64 we have to buy exact then? So what? It's... If you buy exact, it's, what, 6 or 7 extra clicks? You would have to buy backpack first, then, if you want to buy out on weed, which technically is unoptimal and loses you time. Thank you for the 50, Blake. I mean, by the time that you sell on Summer 1st, you're open selling. You're open selling all the jelly. So I don't see how it's an issue. I mean, and then we don't upgrade the axe. We don't upgrade the axe until after the pinch and fall, where money is then the exact same every time. Oh yeah, my PB was unoptimal, if that's what you're comparing it to. But I mean, like, sometimes we don't have to buy wood at all, though, is kind of the thing. And so it's like it really depends on how much just like random wood you collect throughout and how many backups you need to do. In theory, in a perfect run, Court is theoretically correct, where it's worse to do what you're saying because you don't do any backups, and your backup, and during the time that you would do backups, you would be getting the wood while shops open, while the bust happens. It's just like, in reality, we end up playing greedy where we do backups. Like, we just ignore fish and just leave earlier and just deal with it later. And that's kind of like the punishing part. I think the axe change can work, but it's like slightly unconvinced about the extra sprinkler. I think you don't realize how little extra time the turn-ins actually save. Because half the time you're just in a menu. So it's literally just walking between the bundles. You can do them so fast and you actually don't have that many items. And then you can also have the argument that the harvesting will be slower since we're harvesting 4 extra crops every single time. We gotta plant 4 extra crops. Even though that's like hardly a thing. I do a lot of turn-ins while not waiting for Pam. I don't like how we do, like, I hate our 14th, or fall 14th, just in general, because it's like, I know we need to turn in the vault at some point, and this is the first time we get the money to be able to turn in the vault, but it feels so bad because we're not waiting for anything on that day. Because 90% of the time, we don't have the money for fucking robins. And then we end up just doing it on the day that we go out for Pam. That just feels bad. I wish we had a better turn. I wish we had a better date to do those turn-ins. Might mess with money too much. It works in theory, but then you're just gonna screw yourself later, it feels like. If you're not like very exact about your money, which takes time and practice to not only get the hang of, but also the menu to be exact. Because it's like, the blueberry thing would work, but it's like, we would need to be very specific on the amount of money that we get on Mines Day 3 to make sure we don't just immediately lose all that money. And then on top of that, it's since it's I don't know how I didn't die. Oh, okay, of course I died there. We'd also have to, what's the other thing? See how it affects the blueberry buy and sell day. Because we'd probably end up buying more pumpkins that day, because if we only buy 75. I mean, I guess it turns it into money later. You don't have to buy it on that day. This would probably end up buying all the wood on that day. I'm not doubting that there's route changes. It's just, I think a lot of them just end up being washes. Because you lose time to other bullshit. What about that gray or that orange? I do think the axe is a, I mean, the axe is, should be a time save in theory. If money works, and it doesn't make the menuing annoying, it literally saves a walk to Pierre's worth of time, which is what, like, 10 seconds? I mean, you have coffee going during that time, so it's probably less, but still time. And it also makes it not feel bad. I just wanted to loop once. Pass out strat at cleanse. What do you have to sell for it? That's a lot of time. That just makes minecarts even worse. Because that day is the majority of the minecart time save. Did you do it in your PB? I'd like to see what, how you did the money sell. Yeah, no one really does. Nope, I can't get that orange. Because you kind of have to sell exact for that now. I don't find a point. Most of the stuff that I throw in there are the stuff that I'm just going to pick up and then just go to the spot. That's bullshit. I looped though.
Ellie, I'm sure you just woke up or whatever, but I'm done.
I melt by melt, yeah. Heck. I'll have to watch. I want to figure out if Summer 13 passed out the exhaust. Oh, yeah. I'm very, very curious about the cell. Because I don't want the cell to be, like, an exact amount of this and that, because that's, like, dumb. Unless if you can, like, half it, like, twice. Whatever. I'm done. YouTube, thank you for watching. This is going to be a short outro. Appreciate you guys watching. I don't know if I'll be back tomorrow, when I'll be back. I probably just need a break from Community Center. If I want to do something else, I will stream something else. If not, so be it. That's that. Appreciate you guys watching. Appreciate the support. Hope you guys have a great rest of your day. Stay safe out there and just take care. Later. Peace. I am. Leave my hair alone. Probably more. Yeah, well, Raid Lizard. They are doing a subathon, it looks like. They are just be right backing, though. Does anybody know how long they've been be right backing? I hope they didn't just go be right back. I didn't hear that. I'll say it because I don't know when they will be back. So right now the axe feels shit because we go, we pick it up, and then we leave, and then we, you know, drop it off again and then pick it up. So it feels like shit, right? So ideally it's like you go, you drop it off, you pick it up, upgrade it, and then you pick it up again. So it's 3 days instead of four. If money allows it, I would say, because it feels, we do it like that because it's shit because of spring first or whatever. Because we upgraded on winter, we upgraded on that winter day where we buy everything. So we would still end up going, I think we end up going one less day because we don't do that like weird in-between day on the... We just don't end up doing that one weird in-between day in spring. So we skipped the spring Clint visit, but we gotta go the day later. The only difference is, we just skipped that. We just skipped that day entirely, basically. So you go summer 1st, summer 13th, and then summer 18th. And then the 18th is literally just like, you warp to the beach after Robbins, and then you walk up and do the path that way and just go there. So, I mean, in theory, it should save the... Does it even save time, though? Because in theory, all that saves is the walk from Clint to Pierre's, and then you're, like optimally on that day, you don't warp to the beach. You just go straight up to Robbins. So you go back through the farm. So I think the timing is even worse. I just don't even think that works. No, that doesn't... I don't even think that saves time. That doesn't even work. Because the pathing's so shit. We'd have to go out on 3 days that we already go out to. No, you just... No, you would have the axe. You just don't upgrade the axe. You upgrade the axe on summer 1st. So 9 a.m. on summer 1st. Year 2. So you can already clear out the twigs. You'll already have your axe. You skip the one in spring, which the one in spring optimally you would be walking from, like, the only thing that you skip out on it is you would start at Pierre's shop instead of starting at Clint. So you literally just skip the walk time there, and that's all it would save. But then you would have to go out on the 19th, which means you would have to go to the beach. You warp from Marnie's to the beach and then walk all the way
or walk up the right hand side. But I think that's probably about the same speed as just the walk from Clint to Pierre's. So we would have to figure out different days. Piano said we should YOLO the twig apocalypse, but it's like if you lose a sprinkler, your money route's fucked. So you can't really do that. Losing, like, if you lose 18 cauliflower, you're fucked. Just straight up. You don't have money anymore. Do you do it on that day? I mean, you can just do it on... I guess you are right. We do it on that day. I mean, you can start at Clint's and then walk over. But, oh, no, you're right. That is worse. For whatever reason, I was thinking we did it. We did, the axe stuff on a different day. Because, I mean, you would just do the fruit bats in the morning then. And then ignore it. And then just hope you get Fiddlehead Fern on the Sunday or Friday, whichever day you go out. It'd make Wood Skip a pain. Oh, Lizard's back. Okay. I mean, I don't know. I'm not going to think too deeply about it because I'm probably done with CC for quite a while. If you want to, Cord, just throwing out ideas. That's it. We're going to raid Lizard. They are doing some sort of subathon A to Z wheel, but I'm going to go because I need a break. I don't know if I'm going to be streaming tomorrow. I don't know if what I'm doing. I'll be doing a Just Dance stream soon as punishment for not uploading. All that. Yeah, appreciate you guys dealing with my randomness today and kind of just downer mood. Hopefully Friday is nice. Whatever. Hope you guys have a great rest of your day. Stay safe out there and just take care. Later. Peace.